YouTube, welcome back to my channel. My name is Asma Ozaka, if you're seeing me for the first time, and I'm a Port Harcourt based YouTuber. Alright, today's video is on a video that I did 3 months ago. What I mean by is on a video, I'm going to link the video in the description box. Now, the video was on 4 things you should never put on your face. Like, a lot of DIYs are existing, and some of these DIYs are not supposed to be ingredients or products you should put on your face. Now, in that video, I listed about 4 products and I said you should not use them on your face, and I gave reasons why they should not be used on your face. Alright, the reason for this video was the fact that a subscriber sent me a message and she was like, yo, I destroyed her DIY routine, so she's left with no DIY routine. If I ask her not to use any of these products on her face or ingredients on her face, what is she going to use for her DIY routine? So honestly speaking, that message really got to me, and that's the reason why I decided to do a video on 4 things you could put on your face. Alright, this is how the video is going to go. I listed 4 ingredients in that video from the previous video, and I'm going to list 4 ingredients as well in this video, or even more, but this is what I'm doing. I'm going to list one of the ingredients I said you should not use on your face, then give a replacement for that ingredient. Just let's proceed and you understand what I mean. Alright, I'll still follow the same order from the other video, but please permit me, I'll look down a little bit because I wrote it in a book. So I'm going to look down, and then when I list that ingredient, I will now give you the replacement of that ingredient. Alright, the first ingredient I mentioned in that video was lemon. Why would you want to use lemon on your face? Of course, it's photosensitive. It could burn the skin when you go under the sun, especially when you don't use sunscreen. All right, the replacement for lemon could be yogurt. Yes, you could use yogurt on your face. Exactly. You could replace your lemon routine with a yogurt or aloe vera. Aloe vera is very hydrating. Yogurt also contains lactic acid. So, hello, that is a very good DIY ingredients. Now, the second one I listed then not to be used on the face is the baking soda. At this point, I have to say something very fast. Dinah from the Dynamite was in my channel. We had a successful collaboration, and in that collaboration, I was talking about soda ash. And I made reference to the fact that baking soda could actually produce soda ash when put under heat. So why would you want to use baking soda on your face? Like, is your face that dirty that you want to cleanse it or exfoliate? Because let me tell you what baking soda does to the face. It strips the face of its natural moisture, and before you know it, your skin begins to like thicken, kind of. So in place of baking soda, you could use oats. You know, the normal oatmeal we consume, you could use it. Maybe if you like, you could use it just the way it is in flakes. You could also use it, you could use the powder, though I prefer the powder, yes, because the flakes could fall off a little bit. So you could get that and grind it. It's something you could blend into powder form. Is a very amazing DIY. You could mix it with your yogurt, you could mix it with your aloe vera, you could use it with your rose water as well. If you're not using oats, you could also use coffee grounds. Yes, the normal coffee we consume. Yeah, it could also be good for the melanin skin. It could be something you could also use as well in place of baking soda. And you could also use rice flour. Come on, that is even one of the best DIY ingredients, like, I could actually recommend. It has a skin lightening ability. It could add glow to your skin. So in place of baking soda, why don't you look for rice flour? Why don't you look for your coffee grounds or oats meal? Yes, these are ingredients you could replace with your baking soda. Baking soda should be, of course, meant for baking. Yeah, that's what it's actually meant for, not for the face. Now, the third one was sugar. Okay, why I discouraged sugar was this. Now, sugar is something that honestly is it could benefit the skin that is for exfoliating, especially the brown sugar. But there's something I noticed. How sure are you could wash off this sugar from your skin? Now, that's the reason why personally I don't recommend sugar for the skin, because our pores are open, and these pores could actually swallow some of the sugar, like, you know, and it could remain on the face. And mind you, what does bacteria feed on? Sugar, exactly. So that's why I really don't recommend sugar. If you must use sugar, okay, maybe go for the brown sugar. But personally, I really don't recommend sugar for the use, especially on the face. Rather, in place of sugar, go for activated charcoal. Yeah, activated charcoal has so many benefits. And one of the benefits of activated charcoal is the fact that it could draw out toxins. Yes, it could draw out toxins from the skin. It's an amazing exfoliating ingredient. Of course, you could just control it. You could mix it with oils. Yeah, look for suitable oils like jojoba oil, sunflower oil, those oils that are not heavy on the skin. You could use it for DIYs, or you could also use them as well with cream bases or soap bases. I have videos where I made scrub. There was a video with Ucheweze, I made face scrub, and activated charcoal was part of it. I have a video also that I made body scrub with soap base. Activated charcoal was part of it. Rather, I don't use sugar. The last but not the least was coconut oil. Okay, coconut oil is a heavy oil, and when you use it, it's going to clog your pores. And for it, like me personally, let me speak for myself. Let me tell you what coconut oil does to my skin. It causes hyperpigmentation for me. It darkens me. Yes. It also causes breakouts because it clogs your pores. It does not allow your skin to breathe. And of course, your skin needs to breathe, you know. So in place of coconut oil, go for oils that are not heavy, like the jojoba oil I just mentioned, the sunflower oil. It's an amazing oil you could use on your face in place of coconut oil. Those oils, in fact, even help with the lipids on your skin. Exactly, they help you put your skin barrier in good shape. If you have a dry skin, you could also benefit from avocado oil, yes, and also argan oil. Those are oils you could use in place of coconut oil. And one very important thing, the oil of infusion in most of these oils I just mentioned is very important. Let me give you an example. I said the oil of infusion is very important. Example for the avocado oil, I even have a video where I extracted avocado oil using the sunflower oil. So sometimes when you're buying these oils, you ask, if especially if it's an extracted oil, if it's an extracted oil, yes, it's advisable you ask your vendor, please, what was the oil of extraction? If it's coconut oil, nada, run away from it. You could actually manage olive oil, but the best oil of extraction that I use more often is the sunflower oil, because it does not have the ability to clog the pores. So my subscriber has sent me the message, and all the subscribers as well, I hope you benefited from these. At least DIYs are an amazing skincare practices. I do them a lot. These are things that you could use to keep the glow on your face and even on your skin in general. All right, new subscribers, I see you guys. Welcome, 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 and thank you so much. My returning subscribers, without you guys, I wouldn't have been sitting down here. I love you all. I love you all. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. See you in another video. Bye.